hurts.
Hi guys. In this video, I will be showing you a gameplay of me using one of the best marksmen in Mobile Legends, and that is none other than Popol and Kupa. Although a lot of people still think that he is a good tank, but as the title suggests, I'm going to explain why he is a lot more useful as a marksman now. The latest patch involved a lot of marksmen, from simple aspects like emblem, to huge adjustments of marksman heroes' abilities. 1. Many core items of marksmen are cheaper now, and they can even gain more gold from minions and turret shield compared to fighters. 2. They changed the second talent of the second tier in the marksman emblem, from CD reduction to now movement speed, that increases marksmen's mobility and survivability. 3. Many marksmen get buffed in various aspects, such as cooldown reduction, attack range, and damage scaling. Popol and Kupa are the ones who have the most drastic changes. It is almost like a revamp for the hero. I really think he is gonna be a really strong hero in the new meta. Before I begin the gameplay, I really want to break down his adjustments to let you know how important it is to just use him as a marksman and stop building full tank items for the hero. The main changes, in my opinion, are in his passive skill. As you can see, they lowered the stacks required to enhance Popol's basic attack, and they also made it much easier to gain the stacks. Besides, the enhanced attack deals a lot more damage now. That helps him to deal some good poke damage in the early game before he gets his items. The next one is the most important one. Building tank items is useless as it only makes Popol more durable, but Kupa will remain squishy because his HP no longer increases with Popol's. This means that if you still build Popol as a tank, you are basically sending Kupa to die as he can be bursted easily without attack items. Also, this is wasting the potential of the hero by a lot. The other changes are just some damage scaling changes, but there is one good addition here. Also, there is something that they did not include in the patch notes. They actually buffed Popol and Kupa's attack speed ratio. Theirs were only 80% attack speed ratio like Erythal, but now, they gain 100% attack speed ratio from items. Initially, I wanted to show a solo queue gameplay, because Popol and Kupa can be pretty useful for a solo queue player because you are like having a personal tank with you. However, I decided to use this gameplay with my squad because it is gonna be really interesting, and you will know what I mean if you watch till the end.
Welcome to Mobile Legends!
I would be facing Moskov. Even though he's buff a lot too, he is still weak if I focus on him. Like I said, the passive buff is helping Popol a lot, and I actually think it is too much. Just trying to deny his minion waves, but I didn't expect to be able to scare him to use the flicker spell though. Anyway, it's good to have done that. Now he will have to wait for 2 minutes before the spell is ready again. I saw my tank and core on their way, but I think they shouldn't have revealed themselves this early, because if the Moskov had good map awareness, we wouldn't have got the kill here. We've already got what we came for and our tank is dead. That's why you can see I'm not fully engaged into the fight. When attacking someone with a dash skill, try to anticipate their dash before you jump in. This will increase your chances at securing kills. Here, I noticed the enemy mage, core and tank were busy at the top helping the fighter, but they are actually supposed to gank the marksman's lane more so that I won't be able to get fed early. Because of that, not only did we manage to push a turn, we even killed their marksman.
そして唯一の友達
Unlike other marksmen without dash skills, Popol has a skill that can provide vision. Utilize it fully by placing them near the lane you're farming, so you can know when to escape more easily. Here, I noticed my teammates about to contest the turtle with the enemies, so I quickly cleared my lane and went to help, instead of just staying at my lane to pressure Moskov. Securing the turtle and probably get some kills are even more rewarding than just delaying his farm, since he can't do much right now because of the constant pressure earlier. Although he managed to push one outer turret, we killed four of them and got the turtle. Totally worth the trade. Because of my assistance in the team fight, we managed to kill more enemies, that makes us able to take down the middle turret, which is the most important outer turret in the game. Panda is on his way here, so probably Lunox too. Time to back off a little. Don't hesitate to attack the tank when he is out of position but your team is at a good spot. Sometimes they just get overly confident that they can survive. We have got what we came for. No need to force a fight when our skills are on cooldown. I thought my teammates would be able to kill Lunox, so I went for Panda. I'm chasing after the tank not because of being greedy for kills. I actually assessed the situation, and was confident that they can't be quick enough to help him. Lancelot was dead, Lunox and Lupu were struggling to survive, Moskov was still far away. Killing the tank can actually help us to win the next fight much easier, so it isn't a bad decision when the situation allows you to kill him. Once I saw Moskov in the mid lane, it is the green light for me to push this turret quickly.
You destroyed a turret. Killing spree. Ally has initiated retreat. Our turret has been destroyed.
Oof, my team just got shut down by them. I must not let them kill me, otherwise this will be GG.
Bolt is not ready.
Also, have you noticed how great of impact is a marksman to the enemies? Although Moskov was a little under farmed than me, his help in the team fight just helped them turn the table. By the way, the interesting element of this gameplay I meant in the earlier part of the video is about to show up. You can already notice my gameplay is becoming a little laggy.
Ult is ready.
It definitely wasn't the right time to take the Lord. but because of the lag, I thought of just taking a risk to help take it down quick, but that was a huge mistake. You should always stay calm when you are lagging. Don't be like me, starting to do all the mistakes when you feel panicked. Or maybe, I am just being a noob making excuses. Hee hee. After changing my network settings, the game restarts on its own and I was AFK for a while. I didn't believe I can get back in time, but luckily I did. I'm going to show the battle replay of how my godly teammates were playing. This was the moment after Lapulapu killed me. Pretty impressive, what a godly Esmeralda. After about 1.5 minutes, I'm finally back to the game. I wanted to help attacking the Lord, but once I saw Moskov split pushing, I had to defend. They managed to take the Lord, though it seemed like me reconnecting isn't gonna help much. This is when the enemy starts to get cocky to start another fight. Remember guys, after killing the Lord, don't start a fight immediately, otherwise the Lord will just be wasted. The Lord is here, a Kai would most probably try to wipe us out here. Gotta make sure my positioning is good before he jumps in. It is already in the very late game, it is important to get rid of not only the marksman, but the tank too. I have seen a lot of games got an epic comeback because of the tank's perfect setup. See what I meant? Without the tank and the marksman, forcing a fight with us will just be suicide. Three of the enemies are dead. We can take the Lord down easily because of my insane damage now in the late game. Yeah. At this moment, my eyes were on their marksman. It is crucial to kill him to seal the game. Well, at least we got their tank again. In my opinion, Popol is gonna be a really good pick in the new season. The update was just released, so it is understandable why people still mistaken him to only be good as a tank. But, I just proved many wrong in my gameplays. Seriously though, without Esmeralda when I was disconnected, we most probably would have lost.